Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Saratoga Racecourse here on Wednesday. It is August 29th, 2018. Going to look at races 1 and 9 from the spa, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for racecourses around the world. So let's get on to it. Races 1 and 9 from Saratoga. The first race is Over the Jumps. It's an allowance race per $65,000. This race is four-year-olds and upwards. Number 1, 2 races here. Field of 7 horses going the distance of ground of about 3,800 meters, if you'll want to go by that, or the distance of ground of 2 miles and 3/8 over the jumps course, which is the inner turf course. 2 miles, 3/8, 3,800 meters about. Top selection here. I like the number 7 horse. The 7 horse, first Friday, going to go 7-3-6-4 in the superfecta. 7-3-6-4 super. Top selection, the 7 horse, first Friday. 4-year-old gelding by Artie Schiller here. Barry Foley's on this one. The horse's most recent outing came here at Saratoga, 1st of August, 2 miles and 1/16 over the hurdles and allowance race. He finished 3rd by 1/4 lengths there. And, you know, if you watch the race, or before the race, he was very, you know, agitated. He really wasn't, you know, getting a little soapy. And, you know, he that's probably the reason why he lost. He just couldn't keep up at the end. And, you know, he's just a little high-strung that day. Before that, Suffolk, a mile and a half in an allowance race, he finished 5th by 5 1/4 lengths there. You know, it was a flat race that day. And he moved a little bit, but it wasn't enough to win. But, it was a good first race off the break. And then before that, a fair Hills, the 21st of October, 2 miles and 1/8 in the Gladstone Stakes. Horse finished 5th by 9.5 lengths. He didn't jump all that well, and he needed that extra kick at the end. But before that, 2 miles over a hurdle and main special weight. Horse won by 1 3/4 lengths. He jumped well, decent turn of foot at the end. Good race for this horse. You know, if I think he does have the potential to win here. He has a good low weight. He has a good front running style, which you need on this turf course. And I think the longer the race, the better. You know, if he stays, you know, quiet, I think he gets it. So 5-1, I'll take my chances with him. He's either going to run a big race or a shit race. That's my thing on him. So to recap my selections for the first from the spot, I'm going to go with the 7 horse for first Friday. Going to go 7-3-6-4 in the superfecta. So now let's get on to race number 9. The race everybody's been waiting for. Half the people don't really care about the jumps races, but I like them. They're fun races to handicap. But the 9th race, the feature race on the afternoon, good prep race for the Brewers Cup Juvenile Turf. 9th race, it's the With Anticipation Stakes, grade 3, purse $150,000. This race is for 2-year-olds here, field of 12 horses. The 6 horse Unionizer is a main track only. The 10, 11, and 12 are main track onlys. So most likely we'll have a field of 8 horses going on the turf course, going the distance of ground of 1,700 meters, if you want to go with that, with a distance of ground of 1 1/16 on the Mellon Turf Course. 1,700 meters, 1 1/16, Mellon Lawn. And I show the diagram. It just gives me a second to look down at my notes. Just bear with me. Sorry, I'm stupid. I can't do 2 things at the same time. My top selection here. And before I get onto my top selection, this race most definitely should be on the turf course. Looked at the weather report. It looks pretty good this week at Saratoga until at least Friday, so like I said, most likely, unless something stupid happens, should be on the turf. My top selection here, I like the 5-4C now. I'm going to go 5-9-1-7 in the superfecta. 5-9-1-7 super. My top selection of 5-4C now. 5-1, 2-year-old colt by Tiz now here. John Velasquez gets the leg up for Top Hutcher. The horse's most recent outing came here at Saratoga, the 21st of July, mile 16th, inner turf course and main special weight for 85,000. This horse did everything right from the Y poster, went straight to lead on a speed favoring turf course, and, you know, he held on, 1 3/4 length. It was a really good victory there. Major improvement off the start before in his debut at Gulfstream. 5 furlongs, June 23rd, and made special weight 43,000. This horse finished 5th by 8 3/4 lengths there, and, you know, didn't break all that well. It never really got going. I think the mile and 16th should really be up this horse's alley today. He's also the kind of horse, it looks like he doesn't have to set the pace. He set it last time out because he was on a speed-favoring turf course. But today, I think this horse could stalk, and I think he'll really run a big one. Since the 21st of July race, he's been training. Most recent workout on the Oklahoma turf course. 5 furlongs, firm ground, 1:03 2/5 seconds. 17th best workout out of 16 with the dogs up there. And then another Saratoga workout, 4 furlongs, 49-4, the 48th best workout of 83. So his workouts have been very good since the last race. Like I said, he seems like he could be a little bit of a versatile horse. He could set the pace or he could just sit just off of it. I don't think he's a deep closer, but like I said, those two scenarios I think he'll do well with. 5-1, I think he'll do well, so watch out. So to recap my selections for the ninth from Saratoga, it's the Grade 3 with anticipation stakes. Going to go with the 5-horse C now. Going to go 5-9-1-7 in the Superfecta. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck.